So today I'm going to talk about how you can add parameters to multiple component in integrated library. So parameters are a key element of each component, and it is common for many of the parameters to be used across multiple components. I will tell you how you can use the parameter manager and how you can add parameter to multiple components at the same time, so you don't need to do add the parameter individually to each component. For that, what you can do, so this is my integrated assembly library symbol. So for example, here I'm having NPN transistor, and select in symbol, and then it will show you the properties. And in properties, if you will go here, then you can see that I added here parameters like manufacturer, package, it's a automotive component or not, help URL design, and so on, which you can see here. And if you want to add some extra parameters, for that what you can do, and in parameters you can click here add, and in add then there is this parameter. So when you click on this parameter, then it will automatically add one parameter in parameters panel or section. And there you can write, for example, let's say price. So at the moment I don't know the price, so put it here like question mark. Yeah, and for example, if I wanted to add one more parameter for all these components, so what I have to do, I have to either you can do it, go select, go in the properties of each parameter and add here from here one parameter, or what you can do, you can just select all the components from here. So let me select all these components. And once you have selected all these components, then what you can do, you can go to the tools in toolbar, and then here select this parameter manager. In parameter manager, it's important that you should click on parts. It should be selected, and the rest of the things as it is, and meet the following criteria for all objects. Yeah, and then say okay. Once you say okay, so it will show you this parameter table editors for your integrated library, and in this you can add parameters for all the components which you have selected in your either in your integrated library, or if you have selected the component in your schematic, then there also you can do the changes. So there are two ways to add here parameter to all the components. The first thing, that either you can go here, add column, click on that, and then write the name of the parameter which you wanted to add for all the library component. So let's say here is price, and then you can select here add to all objects. This parameter I wanted to add for all the objects, and then value, at the moment I don't know, I mean, as we cannot put the same value for all the components, so just put it here the question mark. After that, say okay. As soon as you say okay, then you can see here parameter price is added here. Then you can go here, say accept the changes, then this window will pop up. It will ask you for your validation, so validate changes, execute changes, and then close. Once you will close this, then you can see that for each component, this parameter which is called price is automatically added with the question mark in the value section. So here, for example, for tire, you can see here in the price section, it's a question mark. It has added this parameter. This is Zener diode. For Zener diode, then necktie, resistance, and this transistor. Yeah, so it's here. Yeah, so that's how you can add the parameter to your complete library, whether it's SMD or THT library. So here, once you added the parameter in your integrated library, then what you can do, you have to save this, and very important, go to project, compile the integrated library. So once you will compile this, then check into your message whether it's successful or not. Here you can see that it's successful, so there is no issue, which means that it has updated all the parameter. And then you can go to your schematic, right click on this, say part action, update selected from libraries, and when you will update it from the library, then here you can see that this has updated this price parameter in your component properties. Yeah, that's how you can update the parameter or add the parameter in your integrated library for all the components. You don't need to add each parameter individually to each component. So thank you very much. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. I appreciate. Thank you very much.